My name is Lori Edison. I am a new postdoctoral fellow at Emory University in Dr. Malu Tansey's lab. I'm working on identifying biomarkers that are indicative of disease states, so things that we can easily measure in the blood that could indicate that individuals are at risk or have a certain disease. And not only can we identify markers, we can identify potential treatments. I think what we're doing is tremendously important because the immune system has been something that has been largely ignored, except in cases where individuals have some immune system problem. But it's involved in everything, and from normal brain homeostasis to disease states, and I think ignoring that very large facet of biology has kept us from being able to find treatments. Now that we're including that in our study, we can understand the brain and body better as a whole. I'm from Fayetteville, Georgia, so Georgia born and raised. When I was a kid, I was kind of a quiet, shy, anxious kid, so I spent a lot of time on my own reading and just observing the world, really, and thinking about how things worked. And I also enjoyed playing softball and team sports and swimming and doing crazy tricks on the trampoline. I think I'm a scientist because it gives me some comfort to understand how the world works and how our bodies function in our environment. And I think it just really answers a lot of my why questions. As a kid, I always had why questions. And I started out as a psychology major when I went to high school, and I thought that psychology would get at my why questions. But I felt that I really wanted to take it a step further down to proteins interacting, you know, the minutiae is where the details are and the clarity. So my great-grandmother had Alzheimer's disease and dementia, and although I wasn't really close to her, I did have the opportunity to see how it affected her. She thought it was the year her husband died. So it's a tragic disease. So I just joined the lab, but I really like it because it's a different environment than where I came from. It's a bigger lab, and it's really exciting to interact with a number of people that have different expertise. So I feel really happy and excited about what I can learn from everyone. I have found it super exciting that I can graduate with a PhD and feel kind of exhausted, and then come into a new space, learning new techniques from people that understand how to culture cells and things like that. So probably my most exciting moment was when I plated some cells in a flask and watched them grow and divide and fed them and take care of them. That was fun for me. So my mission really is to understand how the immune system contributes to normal aging, as well as normal functioning of the brain, and then also disease states. The social aspect of a lab is maybe something that a lot of people don't think about, but it's really important because, you know, we're working long hours and having difficult problems with our science, and having someone else there that understands and is just, you know, reminds you that we're all human and yes, we're working, but, you know, we can still relax and have a good time and enjoy each other's company. I think that's crucial to being productive and happy. So if I could talk to the younger generation and kind of instill in them the importance of scientific research, I would say that, you know, many of the things that we have in our world would not be if it weren't for scientific research. And while it can be challenging, it's extremely rewarding, and you get to ask questions and you get to answer them. And that's probably my favorite thing about science. You get to wonder, and then you get to find out.